What's up, everyone? This is Alastroyer229, and welcome back to Let's Play Tokyo Mirage Sessions, Sharp FE. Last time, we did a little bit more prep work to prepare ourselves for attacking the Shadow Dragon. We did a lot in terms of Unity. We finished up Ayaha's final quest, did a few more class changes, and got a few more items to help us out. In this episode, all of our preparations are now complete. We don't have any more side quests available to us. We've outfitted everyone, we've done all that we can. And now it's time to head to the Cosmic Egg. It's high time we face down against the Shadow Dragon. So now it's time to head forward, and with the barrier gone, we can now enter this idolosphere. So let's enter.
なんと禍々しい気配だ。この先にいるのは俺たちの想像を超えた化け物のようだな。ええ、ガーネフ、なんという怪物を呼び覚ましていったの。急ごう、みんな。光の戯曲を完成させて神竜を呼び出すんだ。
Invaded Illusionary Dolor. So this is Dolor. Huh? A ruined city, what actually more looks like, almost seems like a ruined Tokyo, combined with the aesthetics of the Bloom Palace. And in fact, the illusionary memories as well. Interesting that it's not the illusionary cosmic egg or anything like that, but Dolor. Alright, so what are these? Interesting. Transportation blocks. But when one moves, all of them move. Very interesting. As well as new enemies, I'm guessing. I kind of figured that this outfit would have been better suited as kind of a final outfit compared to everyone else's. But, okay, yes, we definitely have some new enemies. Fujin and Raiji. As well as a Pale Sorcerer and a Pale Sniper. Okay. I'm guessing electricity and Fujin. Wind? It might be wind. Let's see. Unfortunately, I don't know if any of them... The two that I do know are neutral or resists bows. In which case... May as well play it safe and just go after the sorcerer. See what we can do to just get rid of him, and then we can maybe look at those two. I'm not even sure what types of enemies I should even call them. Like Kami characters? Like Kami type enemies? Alright, well let's go ahead and see how well lances work. Javelin rain. One of them was weak to lances. So that is actually pretty good to know. Awesome! And now I can actually see a bit more. Alright, wind wasn't really too good. Ice is okay. Okay. Resists ice, drains wind. The Raijin resists lances? I wonder. Yeah! Called that one! Alright, so now we can see what this Raijin is weak to. Alright, everything seems to be looking pretty good. Raijin's Gleam? Okay, so that dealt a really good amount of damage. And it's weak to bows. Interesting. I'm wondering why Toma doesn't really get into a part of that. Okay. So you're weak to lances. But it's hard to argue against bows. But it's also hard to argue that that's a really crappy session. You know, I'm just gonna have to go with Myriad Arrows. Oh, they're both weak to bows. Interesting. Okay, well that's certainly good to know. And now they're dead. Alright, so we got three new performers. But probably should face them off again since... Could get something more from those Fujis. Anyway, new skill from Chrom, Wind L Thunder. That's actually interesting, because I haven't seen an L Thunder session. Alright, then there's Tharja with a boost to Zondyne. Awesome. Alright, and we have two more Radiant things. We have a new weapon for Ellie, Nidhogg. And a new weapon for Yashiro, Kusanagi no Tsurugi. Alright, well, as we're going through here... Freaking savage enemies. While we're going through here, there is a little bit more that we can do in terms of history lessons. I know that I didn't go through the history lessons of the different heroes, but trying to put in all of them, just try to squeeze in like 7 additional history lessons would have been a little bit much to just try to squeeze in. But we did see 2 very important characters while we were going through those trials. And before we get to that, we've got a level up for Toma! Decent level up. I was expecting worse with the HP and EP. We also get a skill from Navare, Ice Blaze EX. two additional characters that we learned about from going through Tiki's memories. Forsaken Vista. We learned about the Shadow Dragon Medeus and the Hero King Marth. And just in case you were wondering, Kyria's Radiant Unity was Battlefield Lullaby. So, rather than going through a lot of time with the previous heroes, we are going to instead spend a lot of our time going over these two, since they are actually very important. Lock chest over here. Oh geez, And we get a few more skills. Healing expertise! It'd be nice if Hitsuki had any healing spells, which I've made sure he hasn't. Then there's Kida with Fog Breath. Tempting, really tempting. Lower offense and hit and evade. I think I'm gonna pass. I think I would rather her have Tsukukaja. I do have Kane for debuffs like that. So anyway, what I wanted to go over was in fact one of these two characters. And today, I'd like to go over the Shadow Dragon himself, Medeus. Okay, so that allows us to get a chest with Forsaken Tragedy. And that unlocks a Radiant skill for Itsuki, Shockwave. And it also allows us to move these platforms at will. Also meaning I could do something like this. Although I probably could have done something like that before anyway. So, Medeus. Medeus is a character from Fire Emblem Shadow Dragon. He is a prince of the Earth Dragon tribe during the Golden Age of Dragons, long before man had domain over the realm. During this Golden Age, the dragons notice a bit of a problem. And that's the fact that not only were birth rates rapidly decreasing for them, but they were also starting to degenerate, which meant that they were beginning to lose their minds and essentially become feral. There was a solution to this, though. Naga, the leader of the Divine Dragon. What are you doing here? Okay, I was not expecting to find Demon Anna in this of all places, but sure. We get a looming pillar. Titans. Bye bye ho. 232 meters. And currently we're at 48, so yeah, enemies we haven't even fought yet, but hey. Good to know. So anyway, Naga formulated a bit of a plan that could be the dragon's only path to salvation. And that was to take on a human form and essentially changing the dragons into Manaquettes. There's a warp here as well as something else. Wondering what exactly that does. Oh! Hello, what's this? A floating crystal. Seems important. And also a chest with a master seal. Alright. Oh no, open, no, ah damn it! Well, that actually wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. Decent level up for Kyria. I mean, it was just giants and the Kyriettas. So we have Elecblaze EX. Ooh, what do I want to get rid of for this? I guess Ice Blaze? Because I already have Ice Lunge, and I rather would not get rid of anything else. So yeah, we'll go ahead and go with that. Now, when it came to Naga's plan, most of the dragon tribes agreed with Naga. They saw this as their only salvation. But not the Earth Dragons. The Earth Dragons pretty much spat upon anything dealing with humankind. They considered humans to be nothing more than insects. And to take on a form that resembled humans would have been insulting, to say the least. But Medeus chose to follow Naga's advice, and he was the only Earth Dragon to actually become a Manaquette. Sure enough, dragons continued to degenerate. And the Earth Dragons essentially caused a conflict with the other dragon tribes. See what it happens. And we head up. So it's a magic elevator. And it seems like there's danger abound, too. Let me try to continue this story until we get to a decent stopping point in it. So when the Earth Dragons degenerated, they essentially caused conflict for the rest of the dragon tribes. And eventually, the Earth Dragons were conquered. They were sealed underneath the dragon's table, and Medeus was charged by Naga to guard this seal to make sure that the Earth Dragons didn't escape. But things would not go well, considering what would happen next. Unfortunately, this is where we must take a pause in our story, since it seems like we've got trouble ahead. We'll continue the tale of Medeus a little bit later, but for right now, let's go ahead and proceed. Garrick, okay. It looks like we have a little bit of a boss rush on our hands. If Garrick was revived, I'm willing to bet that he wasn't the only one. So let's go ahead and start with a piercing void. Just start off strong, I guess. Deal a lot of damage while we can. And also learn a little bit more about what he's vulnerable to. He only has two skills available to him, so this shouldn't really be too much of a threat, but just be safe. Go ahead and use Rakukaja. Piercing Blade. Ugh. And Mabufu Dine? Okay, so Toma would not exactly be the best person to use here. But regardless, we'll use him the debuff, and then we'll switch him out. So for Tsubasa, keep going what was working. Let's go with a piercing void. Okay, looking at his other weaknesses. So far, the only thing I've seen him weak to is lances. Alright, let's see how well this works. We're doing a good amount of damage to him, though. Alright, let's try Thunderstrike. Resists electricity, so that's a little bit of a problem. Actually, now that I think about it, if he uses Mabufu Dine, maybe he's weak to fire. He's totally weak to fire. Okay, well, that's good news for Tsubasa then. All right, and we're also, he's almost down. Granted, he was the first boss. So, I wouldn't imagine, even though he was revived, I wouldn't imagine he'd be too much of a threat, considering some of the other threats we've taken on. But this should do it. Alright. Sorry, Garrick. You may be stronger, but we are significantly more stronger. And we have a lot more people now. So yeah, you're dead! Again! Get some more prestiges, get a ton of skills. Let's see what we got. We have Concentrate, which I don't really need. But at least Florette has full inheritance now. Next up is Tharja with a boost to Agidine. That's good. I don't really have that many boosts to that, or any. Next is Virion with Lance Plasma EX. Ooh, this is gonna be interesting. What do I want to get rid of for this? Sword plasma? I guess sword plasma. Everything else is pretty much unique, so yeah, we'll get rid of sword plasma for lance plasma EX. And Navare! With speed amplify. Sure, because why not? Alright, so down he goes. Looks like we have a few people who are waiting to be talked to.
ありがとうございます。ありがとうございます。
Realization that the final battle is nigh. Well, we've still got a lot to get through, but we are getting close to the end. Right on until the very end. Alright, so assuming that we just find some normal enemies. Okay, that's what it seems to be. I'm assuming that it's going to be just a bit of an area to explore and enemies to fight. Followed by a boss, one that we fought before. Alright, well, we are starting to run a little bit low on time, but I would like to at least finish off the story of Medeus. So when we left off, Medeus was in charge of guarding the seal to where the Earth Dragons were imprisoned. Over the centuries, he saw just what mankind and the Maniketes were doing to one another. Oh, interesting. Platforms that appear, but are also immune to mirages. Alright. Anyway, Medeus saw just how exactly man and Maniket were interacting with each other, and unfortunately for the Maniketes, mankind persecuted them. And as he watched Maniketes, his own kind, being, well, persecuted by humans, to beings that he considered to be no more valuable than insects, this enraged Medeus. And as the centuries went on, It eventually reached the point that he couldn't stand humanity any longer. He eventually devised a plan to unite the Maniket tribes. And he was ultimately successful in combining the forces of every dragon tribe, save for the divine dragons. This combined power of the Maniket was collectively known as Dolor. This was the birth of the Dolor Empire. Now, with the combined might of the dragons, he attacked Arcania and started a war known as the War of Liberation. Ultimately, he successfully was able to take over the continent. And for 5 years, he ruled the world itself. However, after about 5 years of rule, there was a rebellion that came forth. Different people, powerful figures from before the war, banded together to stop the Dolor Empire. These included Duke Cortez and General Orduin. They led the rebellion itself against the whole might of Dolor. What gave him a chance against the dragons? Well, it was actually the gift of the Arcanian royal family, that which Dolor, or more specifically, Medeus, tried to stop. It was when Princess Artemis gave the fire emblem to Duke Cortis. That is what gave man a fighting chance against the dragons. But when Medeus himself joined the fray, hope for mankind seemed all but lost. That is, until the hero Anri showed up. Anri had one trump card that could potentially save mankind. A blade forged by Naga's Fang, the Falchion. Anri fought Medeus with the Falchion in hand and managed to vanquish the Shadow Dragon. And thus peace returned to Arcania. Don't think you're getting away from me! Oh, he got away from me! Of course, this is all rooted in myth and exposition for Shadow Dragon. The events that I just described happened before Shadow Dragon's events. So what happens in Shadow Dragon? Well, we'll find out after this fight, because we've got a Violet Dark Knight. Technically a new enemy. How do I want to go about this? What are these guys weak to? Swords, axes, and fire. Do I want to use Warcry, or do I want to switch to Kyria? To be honest, Tsubasa's not going to be good against the Dark Knight, and he goes before any of them. Yeah, we'll go ahead and use War Cry. It would be in my best interest if I tried to get rid of as many of these sorcerers as possible. Because Kiria's, aside from using Agidyne, is not going to be helpful at all against the... Well, actually, in that case... Why don't I just switch to Kiria? Okay, so if we use Agidyne, there we go. Now I can get a full session off on with everyone. Perfect! Okay, and we can at least try to thin their numbers. Okay, perfect! Attacking a second one. Alright, and we almost take him down. Nice. Alright, Espada, uh-oh. Oh, no. Crap. Okay, well, this is really freaking bad. Let's go ahead and just use Focus Blade. Alright, so down goes one of them. Okay. So, keeping Toma there was a very bad idea. Or are they gonna use Megidol? Ah, crap. And Goetta? Okay. Let's see what we can do in trying to get rid of these sorcerers. I know Kiria is really weak. But assuming I get rid of these sorcerers, I can severely lower their numbers. Which means less sessions and better chance for me to be able to succeed. Oh, thank you, Kiria. Okay, let's go ahead and use... I'm pretty sure he'll survive, so let's just go ahead and use Agidyne. Get rid of him. So all that's left is the Dark Knight. Alright, try to deal as much damage as we can. Okay. So now Itsuki can go ahead and use a bead on Kiria. Make sure she's in good health. Nice dodge, Itsuki. And then Kiria can use a revival bead on Toma. That gets him back into the fray. And just in time for me to get rid of you. Ooh! Wow, Falling Star would have been really good if that actually came up a bit before. Yeah, we'll go ahead and use the Tunnel Home. It at least gives me a little bit of healing. That's still really kind of weird, considering it's fairy. Alright, well, that at least takes out the Dark Knight. So that's good. Plus, we're getting a ton more Performa. Which is also really good. Perfect. Few more level ups, some more skills, I need to switch stuff out, and a stage rank for Mamori. New Performa, Protector's Gift. And level up for Yashiro. Kinda meh. So we get a new skill from Kane, Strength Amplify. Don't need. I'm good. And that finishes up Gabe Bolg. Next up is Kata with Elec Lunge EX. Wait. Ow. I thought, didn't I get all the repertoires? It's like, right, sessions don't, we don't get those. Elec Lunge. I suppose, I do have Fire Wind. I also have Sword Lunge. And let's get rid of Fire Lunge. Sword Lunge would be better to have in case, well, so that way Tsubasa can get in with more sessions based on Itsuki. Okay, and we get some more Unity Notes. Yashiro has a new weapon, Ragnell. And Mamoni has Endless Song. So, what exactly, if all that what I well, they snuck up on me, but at least I got a few more skills. We got Makarkarn. Makarkarn actually sounds really good. You know, Makarkarn would actually serve a lot more uses than Makajamon. So let's go ahead and go with that. Now the Asterith Rod has full inheritance. And next up is Navari with Lance Blaze EX. Moment of truth. Now I actually have to decide. Let's see. I could just get rid of Lance Slash EX. I'm gonna opt not to learn it. There's nothing that I really want to get rid of for that, unfortunately, so I think I'm just good the way it is. So now the Imatsu has full inheritance. We did get a new performer, so now we have a new weapon for Mamori. Basilikos. Okay, I'm going to go and change up my weapons. Itsuki has the Solakati. Toma has Huo Zhang Zhang. I don't think Kiria has anything now. No, she doesn't. Alright. And that was the last thing for Yashiro. Alright. So while we're exploring here, let's try to finish off our story. So, what exactly was Medeus' role within Shadow Dragon? Well, several decades after he was slain, Medeus was resurrected by Garneth, and followed along in Garneth's plans for at least a little while. With Garneth's help, the Dolar Empire managed to create alliances with the nations of Grust, Gra, and Macedon. And this is partially what prompted the War of Shadows. Now, he once again tried to exterminate the Arcanian royal family. Just like he tried to do during the War of Liberation, so Medeus tried to do again during the War of Shadows. Oh, we get a Balm of Life. But just like in the War of Liberation, when he failed to kill Princess Artemis, another princess escaped from his gaze. This time, being Princess Nina. Once Nina escaped, she went to as you could probably assume, she went to get assistance from a different lordling, a man named Marth. And, alongside Marth's help, formed the Arcanian League. This was an alliance of all of the different countries within Arcania to try to stop the Dolar Empire. Dolar and the Arcanian League would meet time and time again in the conflict known as the War of Shadows. And by the war's end, there was a battle between Medeus and Marth. By the end of this battle, Marth slew Medeus, and the Shadow Dragon was no more. Although there is a little bit of a fun fact, and that's the fact that even though Medeus' title is Shadow Dragon, even though he is called the Shadow Dragon, and the is what the name of the game itself was basing off of, Medeus actually wasn't technically any different dragon. He was still technically an Earth Dragon. The Shadow Dragon was merely a title. But he would eventually become a Dark Dragon when he was resurrected again in Mystery of the Emblem. But as I say before, these lessons are meant to be simply from the basis of Shadow Dragon and Awakening. So for our purposes, Medeus was slain by the hand of Marth. So I've spent a good amount of time just wandering about here trying to tell a story. Let's go ahead and leave the area. We at least have a warp that can take us back here relatively easily, and so the next time that we come back, we... Hello? The next time we come back, I can actually try to be a little bit more focused and try to figure out the puzzle. And, oh, I knew it'd be too good to be true. Anyway, I did want to come back here just to try to make some weapons for Mamori and Yashiro. But looks like we've got a few other things that have opened up to us now that we've entered the Illusionary Dolar. So first, let's see what Maiko has to say, and then Yashiro, and then we'll go ahead and call it a day. Maiko, Itsuki, you probably can already feel it, but I think the final battle is just around the corner. Talk with everyone beforehand and make sure nobody has any lingering regrets weighing them down. I guess that's Maiko's way. I guess that's just the game's way of saying, hey, you're about to finish the game. Do all the side missions first. Speaking of which, a new side story is available. Aoi, we must talk. Come to the cafe. Interesting? He has a rose emoji. There's nothing about it. There's no cartoon or anything. It's just a rose with sparkles around it. And a map. Okay, so I suppose that will do it for us here. Have been going on for quite a while, so I guess I'll go ahead and do weapon fusions another time. And so, next time on Let's Play Tokyo Mirage Sessions, Sharp FE. I'm not sure whether or not to do Yashiro's side mission yet. The reason I say that is because, I mean, I didn't really get all too far in the Illusionary Dolar. I mean, just looking at all the places, especially since I haven't reached any sort of checkpoint, it's kind of hard to justify just leaving partway through. Simultaneously, the game kind of pushes that we need to wrap these things up. So, I think that's probably what we'll go and do. We can go ahead and do Yashiro's final side mission and take care of the last side mission. If we have time, we might be able to tackle Ayaha's request as well. And of course, also make some more weapons, because we could kind of use some more weapons for people. We probably won't be able to do any more dungeon exploration, but we can at the very least actually finish off everything else. We finished off most things, but apparently more things get added. Let's just hope that this is just the last batch of different requests and side missions. So until next time, everyone, take care.